Hi, I'm Andrew Wasson from Creative Guitar Studio. Thanks for joining me for another one of my guitar lessons. This time around, we're going to be talking about how you can get better at phrasing your guitar lines, whether you're improvising or you're writing melodies and composing for an instrumental piece. Now, this came to us as a question from Ross. He's out in Miami, Florida, and he wrote in asking, I'm feeling confused because I keep hearing how guitar players need to work on phrasing lines. Most of the guitar melodies out there use the same scales, shapes, and fingerings, yet everyone sounds different. It's like the ingredients are identical, but the delivery is different. Could you shed some light on the whole area of getting started with developing decent phrasing? From Ross in Miami, Florida. Well, thanks for writing in, Ross. You know, when it comes to doing an examination of how different guitarists will phrase their lines, you know, we quickly discovered that there are specific elements that will definitely be obvious basic areas to concentrate upon. And these would include the line's shape, you know, how it starts, how it stops, and also the relationship of how one line's interaction will connect with the next. And whether it's, you know, Jimi Hendrix or Jeff Beck or Randy Rhodes or anybody else, we'll find that each person's tone and musical personality play a very important role when it comes to establishing phrasing. So let's zoom in on the neck and take a closer look at the collection of phrasing ideas that I've decided to focus upon in this video lesson. And we'll discuss with you how some of the most important parts of guitar phrasing can operate together to start helping you to facilitate the articulation of good phrasing in your own guitar playing. For my first explanation, I'll stick with the scale of pentatonic minor, the most widely used scale by rock, pop, and country guitar players. Now, what's really important when initially working on phrasing with any scale is after you learn the scale pattern, develop the most natural way that the scale falls on the guitar for you. And strive for playing across several frets with an emphasis upon relaxed, comfortable fingerings. So the theme for my first example here is going to be that of maintaining a natural, relaxed feel with a common and very melodic scale type across several frets. In this example, I work between 5th and 12th frets. And basically, here's what my phrase sounds like. Okay, let's move on to the next example. Something important to keep in mind is that within many of the popular styles of guitar players, whether they're writing or soloing, will build up their lines with what is sometimes called building block licks. Now, these are essentially small phrases that over the span of several measures phrase together very unified melodic patterns. And these phrases can be comprised of either small melodic concepts, or they could even be repetitive licks played a whole bunch of times. Now, in my example, I used a recurring rhythmic concept with a melody that continuously pushes the similar melodic phrase at the first beat of each measure until the line wraps up at the final measure. So here's what my phrase sounds like for example number two. Now, in my third example, I wanted to relate the overall importance of bending and sustaining notes for good phrasing of lines and licks, and stress to you how guitarists such as David Gilmour or Jimmy Page or Slash or some of those guys have taken this direction of bending and made this a common part of their phrasing styles. Now, bending really illustrates how a line can strongly draw a listener into the music and at the same time create a somewhat rhythmically ambiguous sound as the listener gets caught up in the sustain of the bend. And it's an excellent phrasing tool that also applies a smooth sense of balance around a lick or a melody, or to use during improvisation as well. So here's what my phrase that incorporates bending sounds like for example number three. Okay, now the final example that I have is one that I always stress with my own students. It's the idea of taking standard parts of other players' repertoire and arranging them, or rearranging them rather, into your own unique musical statements. It's really what being an improvising guitarist is all about. You know, by taking other players' styles of phrasing and reworking examples of other players' musical chops that, you know, they have already worked up to a level of excellence, And it's going to accelerate your own ability at phrasing much faster than any other way that I know. So in example number four here, I'm taking a very Hendrix-ish line and slightly reworking it. So here's what my rearranged phrase sounds like. So to quickly recap what I decided to examine in this video, I discussed beginning with a focus upon having a natural, relaxed feel with a common scale used across a large range of frets on the guitar. Now from there, I moved on to applying what I called building block licks to phrase together unified melodic statements. Then I went over the smoothness that we can create with lines through the application of bends. And finally, I discussed rearranging the lines of famous players to rework already established phrasing sounds and personalize them into your own guitar playing. Now, if you start within these four areas, you'll begin to develop an excellent foundation to the fine art of phrasing melodic lines in your own guitar playing. Well, anyway, once again, thanks very much for watching. Have fun working on this topic. You can download the handout and an MP3 jam track for this lesson over at my website at andrewwasson.com. You can follow me on Twitter, through Facebook, and on my other guitar blog YouTube channel. The links are all in the description box below. Take care, everybody, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.